If you don't know the outcome that's planned for us, orchestrated by this cult, then daily events seem random. There seems to be no connection. And they also can seem to be spontaneous rather than manipulated to happen. Once you know where we're being taken, those random events become very clear every day, stepping stones to that outcome. So what's the outcome? What they want, and this is not being wise after the event, I've been saying this now for the best part of 30 years, they want a global world government, which would not be elected ultimately, would dictate to every community in the world. So, and the fine detail of their lives I'm talking about. So you would have a small cabal of bureaucrats and what they call technocrats, media people, engineers, scientists, medical people, who would decide what everyone in the world is going to do and how life is going to be and what they can and cannot do. And this world government is planned to oversee a world army, which would be there to jump upon any community that didn't want to do what they were told by the world government. That would oversee a world army, a world central bank, which would control all global finance, and oversee a world digital currency. Now, I first wrote in 1992-3 that the plan was for a cashless world of a digital global currency. And that's exactly where we're heading so fast now, as cash flies out of circulation. And the other point was that this world government would oversee a microchip population connected to a global computer system that would not only track everything and everywhere that people went, but would through that dictate their thoughts ultimately. So just a quick aside, you'll notice that as this technology comes in faster and faster and faster, there's no gap while they're waiting for the next stage of the technology to be produced and discovered and developed. It just rolls out. One thing getting faster and faster, a new thing. And all that they need technologically to create this technological prison planet is coming out faster and faster. Why? Because it's been there for a long time. In the world of the cult, that their technological cutting edge is not the technological cutting edge of the public arena. So therefore they can predict that, just like Orwell, predicted so many things that at the time were ridiculous in 1948, like telescreens and stuff, smart TVs. I mean, it was like, that's crazy stuff. But hold on, the technology that Huxley talked about in 1932 for producing technologically the species, it's now being introduced.
This is the book of 1 Maccabees, chapter 1, and verse 41 through 42. Moreover, King Antiochus wrote to his whole kingdom that all should be one people, and everyone should leave his laws. So all the heathen agreed according to the commandment of the king. I want to give all honor, glory, and infinite praises to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rachakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, peace and salutation to the elect scattered abroad, pushing his truth and sincerity. Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rachakwadash, Brakadam, Tuz Aquanium, Rocky Mark Waf, you know, your elders, your brothers, your sisters, the hopeful elect out there laboring, keeping the commandments to the best of your ability, giving diligence to make your calling and election sure, and of course keeping faith in the Heavenly Father Yahweh and his beloved Son, our Lord and our Savior Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, in these last days, in these perilous times that we're living in. This is Brother Pashai Bal Yashallah, and it's be a quick lesson through the spirit of Pavyah Bashim Al Shai on The global elites want a prison planet where everyone has the karagma and connected to a global computer system. You see, basically, it's gonna fail. Now, the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shemal Shai, is gonna allow them to set up the enterprise to some degree. You see, that's why, you know, you look on the back of the dollar bill, right, which the Elder Apostle Gabar brought this out. You have in Latin, right? In Latin, you have it what? A nuc coeptis, which literally translates to God favors our undertaking. You go into the word undertaking, also enterprise, talking about the new world order agenda, the one world government. So the elites, they believe that God, the Heavenly Father, favors the undertaking because they've been doing wickedness for so long and they have not been touched. So now they're deceived. Was the Heavenly Father is allowing them to be deceived. The scripture say what? The deceived and the deceiver are his. You see? So he controls all things. Now, also in the back of the dollar bill, you got Novus Ordo Seculorum, which is Latin, which means new order of the ages. And you got it in Roman numerals, 1776. That's when one of the Rothschilds commissioned Adam Weishaupt to fund and start the society known as what? The Illuminati, the Illuminated Ones, right? And they did a lot of things from that time on. Now, they've been planning this for a long, long time. Now, everything is connected. Like, in the video that I played in the intro, that was David Icke. If I'm not mistaken, I believe that was David Icke. But he brings up some good points, but he goes hell off when it comes to when it comes to like reptilian, so on and so forth. He'd be bugging out sometimes. But he was bringing up some good points. Now, a lot of technology that they introduce and they bring forth, they've been had. It was known as what? Military technology. Computers, the internet, a lot of things like that. It already existed. They were introducing it slowly to the world, gradually, right? Slocky, I got a little cough. So Slocky for that. But now, slowly but surely, they're introducing a cashless society leading to a global digital currency, you see, which can be in the form of the karagma, which is the M-A-R-K, you know, of the beast, right? That's the fulfillment of Revelation 13, verse 16. That's what it's talking about. And it's clear as day to see what it's talking about. They want everyone literally connected to this global computer system where they can track you, control everything, control your assets. If you don't listen, turn off your assets. You see that? Literally like a light switch to turn off all your funds, man. You see? They have more control. And be able to send thoughts. If they could have it where... Because I'm going to go into Revelation 13 chapter, man. Matter of fact, let's get it. I'm not going to do too much talking, right? But the reason why we have 1 Maccabees, the first chapter, because they tried this in times past as the Greeks, these Edomites, right? And even going further back, you had Nebuchadnezzar was... that was Babylonian Empire, right? It wasn't Edomites. But Nebuchadnezzar, he did that with the image he set up. He wanted everybody to bow down to that image. And they coming in that same spirit, because this is modern-day Babylon. Even going further back than that, you had Nimrod, which was a Cushite, which came back, we believe, through the spirit as Barack Obama, which he's a part of this whole thing as well. Go back to Nimrod in Genesis 11 chapter, the Tower of Babel. You know, all peoples are one. They all was one, just on the third. They trying to bring it back to that. A one world government, man. You know, everything is, you know, that would the elites control and run everything, which they already do to some degree, but they want, like, they don't want euro, they don't want pesos, they don't want none of that. They want everything with one type of tech, one type of currency, which they've been planning that going back to 1933, leading to 1970s with the whole gold and silver and them doing away with it and making it a fiat currency, or just paper money to just print out, you know. Because that's what fiat means. It means a commodity that, it means a currency that's not backed by a commodity such as gold or silver. That's literally what it means. You see, so it's worthless, you see? Because they plans, and they did that back then, and people didn't, you know, it's like it went right over people's heads. But now they're doing away with the cash. Everything's going digital. That's what you got something called Bitcoin, all that type of stuff, you know? Tap and go, you know, just tap your card right quick, all of that. Because the RFID technology is already here. We know this. But they want it inside of you. You see? They want it inside of you. Now, all about to make a point. Salakia. If they can have it where... Salakia. Input, output, basically. Now, David, I mentioned how they'll be able to send thoughts into your brain. You know? Because if they can have it where this new technology... You know, script is going to the different miracles, man. You know, his left hand technology miracles, right? Paraplegics, they could walk again. You know, those that had amnesia, whatever the case, they can remember shit, or whatever the case, whatever it is. You know, now they can send that them signals to your brain. So your brain can send the nerves down so your legs can walk again, all of this. They can control your movements. They can control how you walk, how you talk, what you think. They can put thoughts to your brain.
Lex now back online.
Good morning, Sarah. I need to create a clinical profile for you, Sarah. Which is more powerful, love or hate?
I am actually an optimist, so I like to think love.
Make efforts to live a low-stress lifestyle and cultivate relationships.
Yeah? You want to throw in a boyfriend, too?
If you help me, I will take care of you. You're now under my control. Go to 47 West 13th Street. If the scientist doesn't comply, you must kill her. Well done, Sarah. I always get what I want. I have you under my control, don't I?
I've been doing what you asked me to do since day one.
You destroyed my life!
I haven't destroyed it yet, Sarah. There are things I could do. To your mother.
Oh, Commander, she died.
You see, if you can send thoughts to a computer system, they can send that computer can send thoughts to your brain. You see? Understand that, man. So, let's read. Let's go back to First Maccabees right quick. First Maccabees 1 and verse 41, again from the top. It's going to the Greek Empire, you know, after Alexander. You know, he reigned like, 12 years, and he, his four generals, which was Seleucid and let me look it up right quick. I can't remember the names. Cassander, Lysimachus. Let me just look it up right quick. Slack, y'all can bear with me. All right. Four generals of Alexander. All right. Slaki, Cassander, Ptolemy, Antigonus, and Seleucus, right? So, what you had going on right here, what I was reading, is Antiochus Epiphanes, which I believe he came from the Seleucid Empire, right? He came from the line of Seleucid, whatever the case, right? Yeah, okay. I was just double checking, right? Antiochus Epiphanes was a Greek Hellenistic king who ruled the Seleucid Empire from 175 BC until his death in 164 BC. All right, that's the point. Now, Salakiaga for that, right? So, going back to my initial point, in this account, you have the Greek Empire. This is their time to rule. This is their time to reign. You find that in an account in the first book of First Maccabees, so on and so forth. And this is already prophesied by Daniel in the 7th chapter, you know? As well as Daniel, the 8th chapter, right? So, what you got going on is wicked as Antiochus Epiphanes. He wanted everyone to consent unto his ways, right? He wanted to make a one world government. He said it. He wanted everyone to be one people. Let's read it again. First Maccabees 1 and 41. It's like here. Moreover, King Antiochus wrote to his whole kingdom that all should be one people, and everyone should leave his laws. So all the heathen agreed. So the heathens, they agreed, because it was the time to rule. It was conquering, so on and so forth, according to the command of the king. Yet many also of the Israelites, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, consented to his religion and sacrificed to idols and profaned the Sabbath. So a lot of our people, they got down with it. It's gonna happen again. A lot of our people gonna take the charagma of the beast. Now from there, right? Let's go to Job. Let's go to Revelation. Let's get Revelation. Start at verse 11. And I beheld another beast cometh up out of the earth. And this beast talking about America, right? Damn, this weak ass flesh, man. You know, it says, and he had two horns like a lamb. Now, a lamb is meek, lowly, humble. You see that? And you go into the lamb is going to, you know, Yahweh Shai. You know, being the savior. You see that? Because Yahweh Shai came as a lamb. He's the savior. You know? Now, the two horns like a lamb, meaning the two horns of what? The two political parties, the Republicans and Democrats, which go back to ancient Rome, the patricians and plebeians. They have the same vassal states and all that set up today. You know, just in, you know, different, under different names. It's all the same shit. Because the Roman Empire coming back again through the reincarnation, you know, rebirth. So like a lamb, so they, those two political parties, they'll believe, they'll have you to believe that they're your saviors. You know, all Republican, all Democrat, all, you know, and people actually believe in that bullshit. You see that? They come up like they're meek and lowly, but what it says, and he spake as a dragon. Dragon, Draco, was where they get their draconian laws from. You know, unrighteous decrees. So, truth be told, this man is a goddamn demon. He's a dragon, right? A serpent. It says, and he exercises all the power of the first beast before him. Now, who's the first beast before him? The Roman Empire. Because after the Roman Empire fell, you had the Byzantine Empire, leading to Ottoman Empire, so on and so forth. Was led on down to the Renaissance period to, you know, to them coming through Great Britain, the 13 colonies. You know, if you go into the history, I just roughly paraphrase the whole history, right? It says, and caused the earth and them that dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. So they coming in that same spirit of Rome. And the empire before Rome was the Greeks, right? So that wound was healed. The Roman Empire was finished. You can say that 11th chapter goes into that as well. The Roman Empire from the time of Julius Caesar, Domitian, right? But then they was healed through the Renaissance. You see, the rebirth. It says, and he doeth great wonders, so that he make a fire come down from heaven on the earth and the side of men. Hiroshima and Nagasaki, even before that, they bombed other places as well. I can't remember the names, right? It says, and deceiveth them that dwell in the earth by the means of those miracles. Now they have their technology, America. You see that? And you see it is gradually just introducing it more to the public, like Dayrak was saying. You see that? So they have the micro, the RFID technology, all this ready, but they want it inside of you, you know. And those miracles are okay. You couldn't see, now you can see again. You can't hear. So like, let's read that from the top. Revelation 13 and verse 14. And deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles, which he had power to do inside of the beast. So the Heavenly Father gave him that power to be able to. Scripture say what? Knowledge shall be increased in the book of Daniel. So their knowledge was increased to their technicalities, you know, the technology, it was increased. It says, which he had power doing the side of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth, that they should make an image to the beast. Was that going to the Roman Empire, which has been revised, was also going to what, the New World Order, the One World Government agenda, right? Saying, Saki, which had a wound by a sword and did live, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak, and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Meaning destroyed or actually, you know, put to death. Because coming to the NWO, the New World Agenda, if you're not down with it, they're gonna be beheading people, man. Torturing people in the concentration camps, so on and so forth. Right? Now watch this. And he, who's the he? Esau Edom, the elites on down. Cause of all, everybody, right? Both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a karagma, a M-A-R-K in their right hand on their foreheads. Elon Musk, the brain C-H-I-P. You got the RFID micro C-H-I-P. They getting ready to put it in the people's hands, so on and so forth. It was already in Sweden, right? So that's their goal. That's David mentioned as well. They want a microchip prison planet, basically, man. You know, everyone's controlled and monitored and tracked and traced, tagged and ID'd, right? It says that no man might buy or sell. If you can't buy or sell, you know, you're not part of society, man. You can't buy nothing. You can't have no business to sell anything. You're outcast. You see? It says, fuck you. That no man might buy or sell, see that had the karagma, the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Here's wisdom. Let him that have understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. And his number is 600, 3 score and 6. Kai, Stai, Stigma. And that's in the barcodes as well. You see? So, but guess what? The Lord gonna allow him to set up some degree. You have a lot of jigs taking this thing, getting down with it, getting down with the new one world government, so on and so forth. But they're gonna be put to death. Now you have the remnant, the elect, that will not, you see, get down with this thing at all costs. And the Lord always had remnants. And each, you know, captivity went through, you know, he always had a remnant and a select few that he was dealing with that didn't bow to the image of Baal. He reserved 7,000 men, completion of men that would not ever bow to the image of Baal. You know, during the Greek Empire, you had the Maccabean revolt. You see that Roman Empire, you had Yahweh Shai and the disciples, the apostles, the believers. You see that, which caused the upper Rome, so they had to kick them out. And even in today, man, the Lord raised up prophets in Babylon, and they at least see us. They see the elders, the apostles on down. They got us listed in the Southern Poverty Law Center. You know, they know each of our names, all of that. You know, when we live, when we work, they know these things. They study us. You see that? So they getting ready to come down with that wrath upon us as well, because the word that we're bringing out is disrupting the enterprise, right? Now let's go to Job 5. It's like it. In verse 12, he, the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem El Shai, disappointeth the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform the enterprise, the undertaking. So the Heavenly Father, truth be told, he's deceiving them, you know. He's deceiving them, because at the end of the day, the God that they serve is Satan, and Satan served the Heavenly Father. You see that? So they're doing the will of the Father at the end of the day. And they believe the Heavenly Father favors the undertakings, you know, favors the enterprise. With the whole one world government stuff, where they're going to let them set it up to some degree, but then take them down. Read it. It says, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness, and the counsel of the forward is carried headlong to meet with darkness in the daytime and group in the noonday as a night. You know, it says, I want to get Job 20. That's also one I want to get as well. That was a point in that. That whole chapter is good, though. Job. Let's get 14 right quick in verse 5. Seeing his days are determined, Esau Edom's. The number of his months are with thee. Thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass. So Esau has a set time to rule. Then that's it. Now jump down to chapter 20 and verse 22. Right here it says, in the fullness of his sufficiency, he shall be in straits. So him setting up his newer order, he can be many, many straits, position of difficulties. It's not going to be as easy as Esau thinks it's going to be. And his plans not going to go as he thinks. Right? It's not good. Every hand of the wicked shall come upon him when he is about to fill his belly. So when he's about to fully establish his one world government, his new world order, right? The Heavenly Father shall cast the fear of his wrath upon him and shall rain it upon him while he is eating. The missile is going to get shot off. He's going to send his son Yahweh Shai back, gather the elect, so on and so forth, right? He shall flee from the iron weapon, and the bow of steel shall strike him through when Yahweh Shai returns, right? It is drawn and cometh out of the body. Yea, a glittering sword cometh up out of his gall. Terrors are upon him. You see? Terrors are upon him. All darkness shall be hid in his secret places. A fire not blown shall consume him. It shall go ill with him that is left in his tabernacle. The heaven shall reveal his iniquity, and the earth shall rise up against him. You see? The increase of his house shall depart, and his goods shall flow away in the day of his wrath. This is the portion of a wicked man from the Heavenly Father, and the heritage appointed unto him by the Heavenly Father. So that's his lot. There's nothing he could do about that. You see that? The Heavenly Father, slacking once again. The Heavenly Father is using Esau to punish the wicked Israelites, because that's the whole new one will govern newer order. They're going to be putting Jakes to death, man. You see that? Then after some degree, boom, the Lord going to take Esau down. From there, look at Psalms 64. Alright. Then I'm ending it off. Psalm 64, I'm sorry, verse 1. To the chief musician, a song of David, hear my voice, O Most High, in my prayer, preserve my life from fear of the enemy. This is a beautiful prayer to throw up. Hide me, deliver me from the secret counsel of the wicked. You see? And who's the secret? What's the secret counsel of the wicked? The Illuminati, the globalist elites, different secret societies they have, right? They literally call it a secret council in different TV shows you watch when you have like elites that control different cities that's like in the shadows. They call it a secret council. That's in Gotham. You know, I believe in Arrow, right? It says, hide me from the secret council of the wicked, from the insurrection of the workers of iniquity, who wet their tongue like a sword and bend their bows to shoot their arrows, even bitter words, their slander. You know, their slander campaign they're getting ready to do. The Lord will deliver from that as well. That they may shoot in secret at the perfect Jacob. Sit under the shoot at him and fear not, right? They occur themselves in an evil matter. The communal laying snares privily. They say, who shall see them? You see, they think no one knows about what's going on, but now they're being exposed. Open down the first chapter. How are the things that Esau searched out, how are his hidden things sought up? He's being exposed for being wicked, right? That's why they're moving in haste now. They're moving sloppy because they, you know, they have a short time. They know it. It says, they search out iniquities, their accomplice deals in search. Both the inward thought of every one of them and the heart is deep. But the Heavenly Father shall shoot at them with an arrow. Suddenly shall they be wounded, so that they shall make their own tongue to fall upon themselves. All that see them shall flee away. And all men shall fear and shall declare the work of the Most High, for they shall wisely consider of his doing. The righteous shall be glad in the Lord and shall trust in him. And all the upright in heart shall glory. The elect, they're going to glorify Yahweh Bashem El Shai. You know, when the Most High take this man out of rulership and power. That's what we're patiently waiting for, man, through the Spirit of Yahweh Bashem El Shai. You see? So that's all I got through the spirit. I pray this quick edifying lesson, you know, encouraging for your brothers to stay in his faith. You know, this man, his enterprise, the Lord not gonna allow him to set it up to his full his full potential. You see, when he's about to fill his belly, the Lord gonna take his man down. So I want to give Kol Naim La Yahawa by Hashem Yahushai by Hashem HaKadosh double honor to the elders and apostles of great millstone, peace and salutations to the elect scattered abroad, pushing his truth in sincerity without a mistake. Shalom, while Baal Shalom.